It's common to have to store in memory a list of elements. For instance, the travel agency might need to carry out operations with a group of customers who fulfill a specific requirement. Or, we might be asked to process information about specific data on a group of tourist attractions, and this could imply having to temporarily load the lists in memory. To solve this sort of requirement, we must create a structure in memory capable of storing a collection of elements. We already saw that structured data types enable us to define structures that store several data corresponding to an entity. In this example, SDT customer enables us to store information on a customer. With this structure, we are storing in memory the identifier, the name, and the address of one customer. In order to store data on several customers, we saw that we must define the structured data type and then indicate that it's a collection. Let's now go to GeneXus to implement a new requirement requested by the travel agency, which relates to what we just showed. The travel agency is willing to provide its customers with a ranking of countries based on the number of tourist attractions offered. This means that we must show all countries, sorted from greater to the smaller, pursuant to the number of attractions they offer. To solve this requirement, we must first load all the countries stored in the database in a structure, each one with its corresponding number of tourist attractions. And then, we will sort them from greater to smaller based on that number to finally show them either on a web panel or in a listing. Let's then start by creating a new object of the structure data type and call it SDT countries. For each country, we need its identifier, its name, and the number of tourist attractions registered for it. With this definition, we indicate that we will be saving in memory the information relative to a single country. But we need to design a ranking of countries, so we must store several countries in memory. Therefore, we check the isCollection box to have a structure that will allow us to store data of several countries. Note that now this structure includes the same members we defined at the start, though grouped into a substructure called SDT countries item. This substructure was automatically created when we indicated the collection checkmark. Each item will store one country's data, and the group of items comprise a collection. To load the data of the collection, we will use a data provider object. The data provider object enables us to load a data structure, for example, based on data from the database, and it returns the loaded structure. Let's then go to GeneXus and create a data provider object. We select the data provider type and use the name ranking countries with attractions quantity. We can see that GeneXus positions us in the source section of the data provider. Here is where we will declare how we want the data to be loaded in the collection that the data provider will return. Note how easy it is to declare the load. We go to the Knowledge Explorer window, and we find the structured data type SDT countries, and then we drag it to the source of the data provider. We can see that GeneXus automatically wrote several lines of text. These lines of text define, in a declarative manner, the data structure that will be loaded by the data provider, as well as where the data will be obtained for loading. If we now take a look at the properties of the data provider, we will find that GeneXus assigned the name of the SDT countries collection to the output property. This means that the data provider will return a collection of the structured data type SDT countries loaded with data. Since the SDT countries is already a collection, we will not need to configure the collection property of the data provider with a true value. We would have to do this if we wanted the data provider to return a collection based on a simple structured data type. That is something we will be considering further ahead. Now let's analyze what GeneXus wrote in the source. We can recognize the name of the structured data type SDT countries that is a collection. And between the brackets, we have the substructure of the collections item. Let's compare this to the structure of the SDT. We can see that GeneXus represented as text the structure of SDT countries, and provided members' ID, name, and country attractions quantity from the SDT country's item substructure, ready for loading their values by locating them to the left of the equal sign. Since we will be loading this collection based on the contents of the country table, we must indicate to the data provider that it must go over that table, and on the right side of the equal sign, mention the attributes that we will be assigning to each member of SDT country. To indicate which table we want to go over, we use the from clause, and next to it, we include the name of the transaction whose base table we want to go over. In our case, we write from country. When the transaction has more than one level, in order to specify a level associated to a particular base table we wish to navigate, we must write from the name of the transaction dot and the name of the level. So now, let's indicate that we want to load the ID element with the value of the country ID attribute, the name member with the value of country name, and member country attractions quantity with the number of tourist attractions that each country has. So we assign to this member the result of the count attraction name formula. Let's review a concept we've already seen. This inline formula defined will navigate the attraction table by the attribute indicated inside the parentheses. Also, since there's an attribute in common in the tables navigated by the data provider, that is country ID, then the formula will count the attractions of the country navigated by the data provider every time. So, what we did was simply declare one table to be navigated by the data provider, and for each record accessed, we indicated the values we want to assign to a new item in the collection of countries. This group of the data provider is analogous to a for each. And since it goes over the country table, we usually say that the base table of this group of the data provider is country. The final outcome will be that the collection in memory will store the data of all the countries in the database, each with its own number of attractions. We save the definition of this data provider, and we now create a procedure object to view the contents of the collection of countries. We call this procedure printRanking. We now go to the variables section of this procedure and define a countries variable of the SDT countries data type. Then we go to the source, write ampersand, and select our countries variable. And we will load this variable of the collection type, assigning it to the result returned by the data provider we just created. So, we write the equal sign, and we drag the data provider from the Knowledge Base Navigator window. To complete this instruction, we add the two parentheses. With the instruction we just wrote, we are invoking the data provider, which will return a collection of countries that will be loaded in the countries variable. Note that if the data provider required that information be sent to it to work with it, such as, for example, a range of country identifiers, in order to return only the collection of countries within that range, then we would have to add parm rule to the data provider in order to declare those parameters. Now let's recall the exact requirement of the travel agency, to view a ranking of all countries sorted from greater to lesser number of recorded attractions. So, what is left to do is to sort the collection we obtained loaded. That is to say, sort the items of the country collection in order from the greater to the lesser number of attractions recorded prior to showing it. To solve this, we have the sort method. And the syntax is as follows. The countries variable dot sort and inside parentheses and quotation marks the name of the SDT member by which we want to sort. In our case, country attractions quantity. But this will sort the country collection from lesser to greater number of attractions, and we need the opposite sorting because we need to implement a ranking. So, to indicate the reverse order, inside the quotation marks, we add brackets. Now the only thing remaining is to go over the collection again with the data provider and print, for each item in it, the stored data. To go over a collection stored in memory, we have the for element in collection command. Now we will define a one country variable to load in it each element we iterate from the collection. The data type will be SDT countries.SDT countries item, which is the way to write the data type corresponding to each item in the collection. Now let's get back to the source to complete the code that will go over the collection. We write for one country in countries print the print block called country and close the end for. Let's now go to the layout section and call this print block country. We select insert variable, select one country, and we will see that it offers us the possibility of inserting variables for each element or member in the item. We locate the controls in the print block, and all that's left is to define the properties required to print the listing in PDF format. So we go to the procedures properties and indicate true value for main program, call protocol as HTTP, and insert the output file rule, and then we name the listing file as ranking PDF and PDF format. The development of the requirement is now complete. We select run over the procedure to view the ranking in runtime. And we can view the PDF listing with all the countries stored in the database, each with its own number of attractions, with the countries in descending order as requested. So, we've seen the power and simplicity of data providers to load data in a data structure in memory, specifically in the case of the collection type, and we also saw how GeneXus solved everything needed to carry it out. Data providers optionally admit the where clause to filter, like the for each command. They may also be invoked from other GeneXus objects, as we will see further ahead in other examples where they're used. End to end, we update changes in GeneXus server.